Welcome to the rose pollination video, and here's just a general overview and facts about roses.
The purpose of the vodcast that you're viewing is to determine the value of roses to various pollinators in your landscape. We're going to talk about the types of roses, why pollinators visit flowers, and why plants need pollinators. We're going to give you some general rose information as relates to their reproduction. And the main thing that we're going to tell you about is the fact that roses are not very desirable to most pollinators. And some are a little more so, namely wild roses, but in general, roses are not recommended for a pollinator-friendly landscape. We're also going to give you some recommendations for other plants for pollinator-friendly landscapes.
The rosa species have five single-petaled flowers, which can have doubled and repeat flowering. They are hardy from zones 2B to 10B depending on the species. They also contain aggressive root systems to withstand fires. These root systems are able to hold up during erosion and add protection to wildlife.
Native and hybrid roses vary on several aspects in terms of pollinator-friendly attributes. And there's pros and cons for the gardener. Just like every
cowboy sings a song. Roses are visited by generalist insects. These insects collect pollen and nectar from a variety of plants. Some of these generalists include bees, specifically the honeybee and bumblebee, as well as the seraphid fly.
Pollinators visit flowers for a variety of reasons. The two primary reasons are for nectar and for pollen collection. In terms of nectar, it's a source of carbohydrates for energy. Bees store nectar as honey, which we all enjoy and which they use as sources of energy later in the season when there are no sources of nectar available. Bees collect pollen for a variety of reasons. The primary use of the pollen is as a source of protein. This is an essential nutrient for their bee larvae development. Without it, the bees could not rear their young. They also collect protein in the pollen for as necessary lipids for immune systems. The protein also provides sterols for cell membrane development and gene expression systems.
Flowers need pollinators for a variety of reasons. First, improved reproduction success by cross-fertilization as pollen is moved from plant to plant. Increased variability and seed development due to lots of pollen transfer by pollinators. Lack of alternate reproductive methods are also factors that come into play when talking about needs for pollination.
So how do pollinators view roses? Well, generally there's not very much nectar, which is of low value to hummingbirds, butterflies, moths, and birds. High pollen quantity in wild roses is definitely a beneficial factor. The pollen odor is also very attractive to bees and may indicate pollen quality. Also, hybrid rose flowers, due to dense rows of petals, have limited access to the pollen within it. Red color is not very attractive to honeybees, but there are also many other qualities which have not been researched which could be beneficial to pollinators.
Recommended roses for pollinators in Minnesota. Although they aren't the most popular, Minnesota native roses will provide the most pollen and require little maintenance. Try to use modern horticulture roses with open, accessible, and open flower structures, and roses that do not require pesticides, fungicides, or insecticides. Every rose has its thorn.